Welcome to another tutorial, this time 3DVista and Google Analytics 4. And as you can see, I'm receiving some data. And this has been a struggle because there used to be Google Analytics 3. And then Google decided to go for Google Analytics 4. And then it was possible to add, instead of a UA code, to add a G code to 3DVista projects. But nobody had any clue how you could get Google Analytics 4 working. So then it was the 4th of January 2021, and this wonderful post came from Jess Bitstrip. So once you have your Google Analytics account and you're sure you have Google Analytics 4, you have to set up a property. So let's do that. So we go to you have like different accounts. I'm going to keep it within this account. This is just old stuff, basically. Basically, it's best to like create one account for like a client, for example, which a client might have different properties. Or you have all your virtual tours in there and maybe another account for website. So that's kind of like how you can see that. And within each account, you have different properties. And so I've created an account virtual tours. And in there, I've created like different properties. I've removed Talos because I'm going to add that one again. So that's why. Let's say you only have an account and you don't have any properties, then you are going to click a property to create a property. And you'll have to call this a name. So I'm going to call this Talos and tutorial video. Time zone, I don't know how important that is, but I'll just do it properly. And I got euros. And for the rest, I'm just going to leave it for as it is. I'm not a Google Analytics expert. I just do what's necessary to kind of like get to the result. Whatever. I don't really care. Let's just say others. And just go for create. Set up data stream to start collecting data. So this is an important thing, because once you have your property, you still need to add your data stream. And I believe you can have multiple data streams, but I'm not sure. Again, I need to play around with it more. So, let's go for web. And the place where I'm going to receive my, which I want to measure, is vt.360creators.com/talos. So let's go there. I'm going to copy this link. And I already uploaded the tour, and this is something to keep in mind, because in the uploaded tour, I have not added any Google Analytics codes yet. So this is still an old tour, which I need to replace later on. So I take this URL, I go to set up web stream. Well, it's always HTTPS. If it's HTTP, please change that. And I'm just going to call this stream, VT, but basically the same. I'm just going to leave this for what it is, create stream. So now I have set up my stream. And now the thing that I have to do is I have to take this measurement idea and I copy this. I go to 3DVista, my project, where I have my Talos project. My old Google Analytics 3 code is still in there, probably it's empty for you. I'm going to remove this and I'm going to paste a new Google Analytics code, and I'm going to publish this. So what we'll have to do now is delete the old tour and upload the new tour. So right now everything's uploaded to the server. I can go here, I can refresh it. You will not notice a visual difference, but it is uploaded. So right now what we have to do is we have to generate a little bit of user data. So just clicking around, letting people do something. So there is something generated. Then what you do is you go to, and this is where the magic happens, all events. You go to manage custom definitions. Yes, you create a custom dimension and having this one selected. Then you click label, or you set label without any capitals. Then this is something you can rename to anything you like. That doesn't matter, but this matters a lot. So keep this label and then save this. And now basically, go back to the tool once again. I think this second time it actually matters after you've created the label to click around so that there's some data through the stream. And let's see.
Hi, my name is Sigrid.
So what we do now is, right now you don't see anything happening. Oh, you already do. Okay, so I'm lucky. So sometimes you have to wait 24 hours before you see something. And well, in my case, I'm already lucky and I'm already seeing data. So I'll open this now in Incognito.
With 80,000 people worldwide and 2,000.
So if I'm correct, then it will show 2 users in the last 30 minutes. View real time. So right now, yes, so there you go. And as you can see, I'm living in Enschede. So and now you might be wondering, so how does that work with all the events, and how can you generate reports with that? Well, that stuff I also don't know yet. So if you do know, please let me know. I'm really happy to collaborate and make a new video about this, how you can take this to the next level. So for now, I wish you good luck. Happy playing around with the Google Analytics, and see you in the next video.